Thank you everyone for coming. We're so excited, so amazed that this is our 5th anniversary. And I want to thank all my helpers, Sue Kelly, Jessica, Karen, Christine, Tony, all my teen helpers. This event would definitely never have happened if I didn't have your help. I love you all, and I thank you so much. And thank you for all the people that came and always support us by coming out and joining us to have this great event. Have fun! We're a food-free, allergy-friendly trunk or treat. We always invite everyone. Just because we do food-free, allergy-friendly doesn't mean that we exclude anyone. We love that everyone comes. We love to have everyone come. It just means that we make sure that everyone is safe and included. When we have this event, it's so important for all our allergy-friendly families. They love to come and know that they will be safe and that they can come here and not have to worry that anything is going to hurt them. These families plan months in advance. They plan out their trunks, they plan out their themes, and they just know that there's such a wonderful community here, and they feel so loved and happy that they have this here. And I am so happy that I can do this for them, and I do this in memory of my son. Halloween was always one of his favorite holidays, and I knew that this was a way to keep his memory alive. As you can see, we have a really great turnout. We don't have as many cars this year, but it seems like we have more walkers than cars, which is great. It's just great that we have so many people, and I just love doing this, and I'm just so happy that everybody comes to have fun.
The ghouls all came from their humble abode to get a jolt from my electrode.
They did the mash.
They did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
They did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
They did the mash.
They did the monster mash. The zombies were having fun.
In a shoebox.
The party had just begun.
In a shoebox.
The guests included Wolfman, Dracula, and his son.
Hi, we're here today at the Food Allergy Awareness event, and we got the electric chair for the Halloween Trunk or Treat by PAC 85, and it's a great fundraiser, and everybody have a great day.
The holiday mashup idea came in the middle of the night. I thought about the holidays that were coming up and that we were going to be getting ready for, and I thought it would be a fun idea to do that for Trunk or Treat. So that was the birth of the idea, and this is our second year coming, and we're really excited to be here.
Hi, my name is Lily,
and I'm Annabelle,
and we're at Trunk or Treat, and this is our third time doing Trunk or Treat.
My second.
The first year we did a Hawaiian theme, and the second year we did a Harry Potter theme, and now we're doing a Western theme.
Okay, never mind, it's my third time.
So we decided to do this theme because at our school last year, we had like a dance.
A father-daughter dance.
And they gave us the leftover cardboard things.
No, they stole the leftover.
No, they gave them to us. And then we decided to add some things of our own and make a cool Western-themed trunk.
So we have mazes, horses,
snakes, stamps.
And puppets. We have puppets. Do, 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 do.
And stickers.
And you can make a little play with the puppets like this.
And we made signs that says like want, oops, like that says like wanted, and like if they find, it's like a joke, like if they find us, we'll give them like a trunk or treat prize. Or some people wrote like $10,000 and stuff. So yeah.
Welcome to our fifth annual Halloween food-free, worry-free trunk or treat. My name is Sue Kelly. I'm a nurse and I'm a food allergy mom. This is my fifth year helping my dear friend Georgina Cipriano, who lost her 14-year-old son to anaphylaxis from food allergy 6 years ago. His favorite event was Halloween, so we do this each year in memory of Giovanni. And we come, and as you can see, the cars come and they decorate, and they have a theme, and they usually have a game. And we give out all food-free, candy-free treats. So there's no worry here. Halloween can be a very scary time for families with small children with food allergies. They're learning how to navigate. It might be a new diagnosis. They've never dealt with Halloween before. And Halloween, as we all know, is usually focused on candy. And those candies can actually take the lives of these little children. So they have to be so vigilant. And they're also learning how to have good manners and be gracious. And it's just a very awkward and difficult experience. So we take the fear out. We have the kids come down, let them just be one of the bunch, and have fun at Halloween without any fear. So welcome to our event. It grows every year. We started off the first year with like 5 cars, I think. And now we're up to, I think we had 40 cars sign up, and we have a bunch of walkers. We're just getting going, so the party's just getting started. Thank you again for coming and for all your support over these years. It means so much. And we also have our emergency responders here this year, and they're so supportive. And they understand how to respond to an anaphylactic emergency thanks to our great town and initiatives by Georgina. Our ambulances are stocked with epinephrine, so we are really setting precedent for the state of New York and for the country. So it's great to have this event. Thank you again.
So we're here today to help anybody who needs to know how to use a epinephrine pen. That is an EpiPen for short. That's what we use if someone's having an allergic reaction. And every household should have it if you have an allergy in your house, so you're aware of it. It's a very simple injection. You would remove the top piece. This is my friend Fran that's helping me here. And you would take the orange piece and you would put it through your clothes, right through your clothes on your thigh. And you hold it for 3 seconds. 1, 2, 3, done. The needle retracts, so you don't have to worry about anybody getting hurt then by a needle. And that's it. It's as simple as that. You can administer at least 2 in your household, but if you give 1 to someone, you should call 911 because they need to get to a hospital in case they have go into anaphylactic shock. All right, and the ambulance has more medication to help with that.
From Rocky Point, and we've been coming to the Love for Giovanni Foundation Trunk or Treat for the last 5 years. I think we can all agree that this is one of our favorite days of the year, right guys?
All the Girl Scouts made emojis on my group of Girl Scouts. I loved it when we did that. And we did that at West End. Daddy, I love emojis.
You
want to
pass it to Kaylee?
I love the event because we got to go to a lot of cars and we got to see what they have. My favorite part was selling our stuff.
Okay.
Lily, good
job.
My favorite part was getting all of the stuff.
Do you want to go to jail?
What are we doing?
What's your favorite part?
Your favorite part?
Getting my face painted. Getting my face painted.
Happy Halloween.
Hi everyone, we're at the Trunk or Treat for Allergy Awareness, and we want to thank Georgina and everybody else for this great event. We come every year. And you want to say something?
Hi.
He's been coming for many years. He's now 10. He's inside. Say hi.
Hello.
Say thanks, Georgina.
Thank you.
Happy Halloween, everyone.
Hi, I'm Mateo Marquez, and I live in Baldwin, and this is my first time at this event. It's the Trunk or Treat event. People come and they set up their trunks full of different themes, like Christmas themed, Halloween themed, and it's really cool. I'm a volunteer here, and we just hand out, like different things. I have a dairy allergy, and I really like to do different volunteer events because I know what it would have meant to me when I was a kid to have all these things around. And, you know, I want to, you know, be a part of things that create a safe environment for these kids. And I just want to be a part of more of these things in the future. I think it's just really cool to get other kids involved and to have them grow up with all these events. And, you know, I think it's just really special to be a part of these.
Hi, my name's Stephanie Sorkin. I'm the author of Nutley the Nut-Free Squirrel. This is my second year coming to this event, and I'm so excited to be here. I hope that it's an event that she does every year, and you could see the turnout here is amazing. I wrote Nutley as a bedtime story for one of my kids who has multiple food allergies, and it kind of snowballed where it had a beginning, a middle, an end, and then I realized that I would love to share this with other people, so I had it published, and now I go to schools, I go to tons of events like this, and I do it to spread food allergy awareness. I also donate 100% of the proceeds to a food allergy organization called FAIR, which stands for Food Allergy Research and Education. So I'm really excited to be here, and you could see that it's a great event.
For my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise,
he did the mash.
He did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a great.
Hi everyone, this is really a great day. We're here at Trunk or Treat here at Grace Park, and as you can see, there's a nice crowd, and I just got electrocuted. I'm here with Rich from Mako Plumbing. Him and his Boy Scout Pack 85 put together a little electrocution, it was my obligation that I had to get electrocuted, and it's really quite it really is amazing. Can you scoot the camera over this way? We can see it a little bit. Or did you saw this already, Richie?
The smoke's still clear.
Richie, I'm here with Deputy Mayor Mike Hawkhurst, Anne-Marie Reardon, Trustee, and Rob Baccio. And Richie, could you tell us a little bit about this contraption you put together here, this electrocution chair? I understand your son is also calling the governor to try to get a stay.
the mayor he should be calling. Pack 85 put this together for this trunk or treat, another trunk or treat, and everybody seems to be enjoying it. We got a lineup of people waiting to get executed today.
Anne-Marie is going to get in there next, so if you want to stick around, you can actually see the electrocution. We're just waiting for the extension cord to be running. Anne-Marie, would you like to say
yes? Well, it is always an honor to come down here. It is such a wonderful event to see all these kids down here, all these families down here, able to celebrate Halloween who have food allergies. This is a food no-no place. It is a food-free, it is all jam-packed with fun, but it's great to see how it is become bigger and bigger each year, and the amount of people that truly are invested in a safe event for kids with allergies. Rob?
Yeah, no, it's a terrific event and an awesome turnout. I think this is one of the biggest turnouts they had in the last, 5 years now they've been doing, right? Yeah. So it's great to see the community support, Lindbergh people coming together, and people from all over, people coming from the tri-state area to join in. So if you haven't got down here already, we hope you had a chance to do so. If not, look for it next year. Mike?
Yeah, thank you. You know, as was pointed out, this is the fifth year of the event. It's grown each year. We have a beautiful day down here. And, you know, it's something that, you know, we have kids down here in costumes. And like Anne-Marie pointed out, they don't have to worry. Regardless of what food allergy you have, it's a food-free event. The cars are decorated. It's fun. Richie's done a great job. He's got a line here at his execution chamber, you know, for people waiting to get in.
Are you going in next?
Well, we'll have to see about that. But, you know, it's really a fun day. And we have to thank, you know, Georgina Cipriano and Sue Kelly, who put together the work to put this event together out of their heart to come, you know, and it is a lot of work to get the people down here, the cars, the setup, you know, the DJ, they have the fire department down here, the police, the ambulance. But, you know, again, it's a great event. And, you know, to see the people of Lynbrook and, like it was said, people from all over the area coming down, you can't do better. And, you know, on this fifth anniversary, we do want to wish Mayor Allen Beach a happy birthday.
Yes. Happy birthday, Mayor.
Thank you, Anne-Marie. Michael, I really appreciate that little dig. That's all right. We won't go there. This is really unbelievable. As we're standing here just a few minutes, it's getting crowd. More people are coming. So this is really a tribute to the hard work by the people that put this together. Thank you all. I really wish you would come down here and join us.
And this is?
Gabby.
And Gabby is allergic to all nuts, and this is a wonderful event. It's our first year here, and Gabby is loving every minute of it so far. She's made a new friend, right, Gabby, who is also allergic, so that's wonderful to meet other children just like her, so she knows she's not alone. And we're just enjoying every minute, and go Teal Pumpkin Project and go the Love of Giovanni Foundation. Thank you for organizing this event.
Hi, I'm Christine Weston, and we're at the Trunk or Treat this year for the children with food allergies. My daughter has a milk allergy. We've been coming for over 5 years now, and I just think it's great that the kids have an opportunity like this to trick or treat safely.
Thank you. How you doing? We are so happy to be here. This is actually our first Trunk or Treat, and we're so excited because it's really the first time that we haven't had to worry about food allergies. Both of my children have food allergies. So thank you.
Coming out. It's an amazing event. It's been so great to see everyone. We've had a wonderful crowd. I want to thank the Lynbrook board. Thank you to the Lynbrook mayor and to the whole community. You always show so much support. Thank you for joining us and for coming out to thank you for showing your support to bring Giovanni's memory alive, because that's what this is all about, and to show camaraderie to the food allergy community. Thank you. We love you.